Hello friends, I'm Paulshinn, the guy on YouTube making Model A's cool again and the Model A Ford Club of America technical director. So when you're going downhill in your Model A using the engine braking to hold you back, does it go pop, pop, pop through the muffler? Or maybe when you're between shifts as the engine's coming down in RPM for the next gear, does it pop, backfire through the muffler? That could be an exhaust leak. Today, I'm going to show you a couple of ways how you can fix an exhaust leak in a Ford Model A. Today we're going to be using my wife's 1929 standard Roadster to talk about exhaust leaks. There's a couple of places you can get exhaust leaks in a Model A, and thankfully they're both under here. So number one could be the exhaust manifold, which is this big chunk of cast iron right here. There are four exhaust ports on the side of the Model A engine block that go into this manifold. Any one or more of those leaking, if a little cold air gets in there, those will start igniting the unburnt fuel that's in the exhaust system. There you go, there's backfiring. The other possible cause is right here, the junction between the manifold and the exhaust pipe. Right in here is a real common place to get exhaust leaks. Today I'm going to show you how to repair exhaust leaks in both of those locations. So we're going to go ahead and take the fuel line off, rotate that around. You could do that. Take the linkage off. I'll pull the choke rod off, and then we're going to use our 11/16 on a extension, and we're going to take the bolts loose and see if the whole manifold just comes off in one piece like it should.
That'd be beautiful.
Get to work.
All right. Get to work, jerk.
Now I'm just going to come out with the 11/16. So I'm going to loosen these up in sequence, and I'll take them all the way off here in a minute. And then when we put this back on, we're going to use the torque wrench, and we're going to get it exact. Ooh, this one's tight. I don't know if the nut's coming off or if the whole stud's coming out of the block. I don't know yet.
Oh, wow.
Let's find out.
Oh, it's just
whole stud's coming out.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
That's okay. No, it's no big deal. Stud can come out. Oh, somebody put some thread letter goer stuff on there. Okay, fine. Okay. Grab a rag off the bench, please.
You got it.
There we go.
So much for not wanting to scratch up.
Yeah, you know what? That didn't work out, did it? All right, here we go. There we go. Oh, hey. It had the rings. I'm impressed.
Wow.
All right. Yeah, they all fell out. So now I know they weren't stuck in there, and a bug flew out. I don't know how that happened.
A bug flew out? Yeah. Oh, my God. You're living a bug's life in there.
I guess. So that bug is higher than Willie Nelson right now.
Oh, the light.
Well, let's see. These are the manifold gaskets I don't really like. But okay. You know what? I can see right now where it was leaking on the back of number four. Was leaking on the back of number two. So there's your exhaust leaks, and it looks like by the corrosion, this is where the intake leak was, right here. So these were definitely leaky. Let's get these off of there. Not good. I left some behind.
Let's need a knife of some sort?
Oh yeah, we're gonna need a scraper. We're gonna have to clean this all up. There's a few different kinds of manifold gaskets. These are the ones that I prefer. These were used from January 1929 through May of 1931. These have absolutely the best seal. I also like to use the gland rings. There's a lot of controversy whether or not to use gland rings, whether or not you actually need them. The answer is yes, you do. And clean it up with some lacquer thinner.
Nice.
So what I do is I take a sock and I put it on, but not quite all the way.
Yeah.
Then you take the end and then you tuck it in like that. You make a little puppet. Hey, what's up? And then you use that with some lacquer thinner on it.
Nice. Did I do it right?
Close.
Close.
Your puppet has a cleft palate.
Look at.
There you go. Now your puppet's gonna be.
How dry I am. All right. We got a pretty darn nice surface to work with now.
Cool. Okay. I'm gonna get some cardboard so we can go.
Looking pretty nice.
All right, you ready?
I think so.
Get your hand out of there. It's going to get on.
Oh, then it's not going to stay where it needs to be.
Move.
Oh, that's
not going to
stay. It's okay.
It's close enough. There.
Wow.
Complete. See how pretty that looks?
Oh, fudge.
Little fuel.
Oopsie.
You jiggled the handle. All right, that's good. We'll let that dry real quick. Then that way that won't rust. We put the new stuff on there. You'll be all perfect.
brand new motor.
Yeah, sure. Let's go with that. You've been sniffing too much lacquer thinner. I'm gonna put the lid on now.
Party time.
So while I'm waiting for the paint to dry, what I'm gonna do is check the manifold for flatness. Now, number one, I wanna make sure that there's no difference between the exhaust and intake ports. Number two, I'm gonna check to make sure that there's no sagging on the exhaust port on number four. I'm just using a straight edge here because it's going to be close enough for this project that we're doing. If you want to see how to exactly check a manifold for flatness, I did a video that contains that information. I'll link to it right here. So go check that out. Meanwhile, just using the eyeball method here, it looks like somebody has already had this on a machine because it's perfect. It's absolutely perfect. Okay, good. Let's clean it up and roll with it. Before reassembling, I'm gonna just make sure that there's no residue left. Take a nice flat file. Since I know I've got a nice flat surface, I'm gonna hit everything. Make sure there's no old gasket left over. Let's get this cleaned up, ready for our new gasket. Ooh, look at that. Perfect. Those of you that have been watching my videos for a while have already seen this. So I like to take a little lacquer thinner, clean these up, make sure there's no oil deposits left on them from manufacturing process. Since the Model A engine block is kind of porous, I like to use a little bit of mega copper on the engine block side only. I don't put any of this on the manifold side, just the engine block side. Pro tip, if you don't want your stuff to dry out, don't use the little plastic white caps that go over the end. Use these and just don't cut the end off. Then it'll never dry out. Okay, goop side towards the block. Just stick them on like that. Now this side, unfortunately, this nut is stuck on this stud. So what I'm gonna do is just line this up. I'm gonna have to put this on after the fact, but for now, just to get it to line up, I can do this right. Put this stud in temporarily. And then I can just get it to line up and sort of glue itself onto the block. Just leave it sit for a minute, then I'll pull this out. There we go. Okay, just leave these sit for a little bit. Just kind of skin over. I don't want it to dry, I just want it to skin a little bit. Just hold those on like that. Now's the time to insert the gland rings. I like the ones with the little slot on them, so they put a little bit of pressure against the manifold. So I install them so that the slot is kind of towards center so that I can see if there's an exhaust leak there. So just slide them into the recesses in the manifold. Spring tension on that one. I know you can't see exactly what I'm doing. In the other video I mentioned before, I show this in great detail. Right now we're just in a hurry to get Model T's car back on the road. I pulled the stud out that has the nut stuck onto it. And we're going to go ahead and put this manifold in place. I've got the gland rings in. We're going to be very careful here to make sure that we don't mess this up. About like that. Nice fit. Okay, now, these washers, one side is concave, the other side is crowned slightly, okay? You want the crown side towards you, the concave side towards the engine block. I'm just going to put this nut in place. Get this started so it holds. So I don't have to worry about it falling off. Not worried about torquing these yet. I'm just holding this in place. Now I'm just gonna snug these up a little bit. I'm not gonna torque these yet. I'll pull the torque wrench out and torque them up. But for right now, I'm just gonna get this thing on here. All right, the torquing sequence on this, I'm gonna do it first of all at 25 foot-pounds. Okay, now I'm gonna crank it up to 30 foot-pounds. That barely moved. Okay, now we're gonna crank it up to 35 foot-pounds. And I do these rear to front or front to rear. You don't do it from the middle out. It's not like a head. Okay, here comes the controversial part. You ready?
Yeah.
I torqued these to 40 foot-pounds.
Yeah. What's initially controversial about it?
That's a lot.
Yeah?
But the reason is that Sif's going to squish. Hmm. You want these to come loose? No, you do not. So I torque them to 40 foot-pounds. Right there. I can still do it with one finger. It's not like it's that tight. The other controversial part is using an extension on my torque wrench. People say you can't get the proper torque using an extension. You can if you use your other hand to support it. Hmm. There it is. Ta-da! See, now I just got to put all the stuff back on and done.
Yeah.
Up, should be ready to go. Brody has a slightly unusual aftermarket clamp. There's no nuts behind it. I guess it's just bolts, so it shouldn't be too hard. Let's get the clamp off. Okay, this has one of those inserts and the little ring thing in it. So people that say, oh, well, throw that insert in there and that'll prevent exhaust leaks. Well, here's an insert in Brody's exhaust. Brody clearly had an exhaust leak. That clearly does not work. That's why you need an exhaust system with the proper flange. This thing will not have an exhaust leak when I'm done with it. I'm going to get this muffler ready to put on. First thing I'm going to do is clean this flange really, really well. Make sure there's no oil or grease or anything on it. In it, some lacquer thinner. I'm going to get some high temp RTV here. Pro tip, if you don't want your RTV to dry out, don't use a little white plastic cap. Use that cap. Just don't cut the end off. And then it's always ready to go. It never dry up on you. Put some of this around the edge here on the inside. I'm not going to cake it. I'm just going to put a little around the edge. And then I'm going to let this kind of start to dry. Just skin. I'm not going to let it dry all the way through. I'm going to let it skin before I put it on the car. This will never, ever, ever leak. With the new exhaust ready to go, I need to clean up this exhaust manifold right here. I'm just going to get all this soot and everything off of here and clean it up. Make sure that I get a really good seal. Luckily, the surface of it feels pretty good. There's no gouges. There's not even a scratch in this thing. So I think this is going to be fine. And just definitely don't use those sleeves and all that. That's just a Band-Aid. That's not really a thing. I've got the jack sitting under the muffler with a rag to kind of cushion it. And I'm just going to wiggle this into place. I'm going to push the whole thing back just a little bit. It's almost perfect. That is darn near perfect. All right, just bring it up, put some pressure on it. You can feel the car come up a little bit. Wiggle. All right, now I'm going to feel around and make sure that it's flat all the way around. It needs to go that way just a tiny bit. Go under here and wiggle just a tiny bit like that. Okay, let's feel again. Wiggle, pump. All right, that feels really good. All right. I'm going to give this project a little extra respect. I'm going to use an original muffler clamp on this. I don't know why. I should just use a repro, but I'm going to use a good one. So this is a muffler clamp, an original one. You'll notice that one side has a little bit longer edges than the other. The top is the narrow one. The long one goes on the bottom like this. Before it gets real hot, I'm just going to feel around the exhaust leaks. Nothing to see here. Just two cool people out doing cool people things.
Woohoo!